keeping with the spirit of reconciliation, we want to acknowledge the Turrbal and Jagera people, the traditional owners of the lands where this university now stands, and recognise that these have always been places of teaching and learning.
We wish to pay respect to their elders, past, present and emerging, and acknowledge the important role Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander people continue to play within the Australian community.
Jake and I are your tour guides for this weekend's magical mystery journey through the woo-filled world of quacks, charlatans, climate change deniers, creation scientists, psychics, anti-vaccine campaigners, and wellness bloggers.
Our speakers are doctors, scientists, psychologists, academics, teachers, and educators, researchers, and writers.
Yeah, but what would they know? I bet their chakras are all out of order.
Well, our speakers are not just scientists and academics. They're magicians, they're photographers, they're parents, musicians, cancer survivors, and they're living with a range of disabilities.
They're artists, collectors, and connoisseurs of various alcoholic and caffeinated beverages.
Now, don't be shy. Most of our speakers will be with us throughout the weekend, so please introduce yourself during the breaks. You may well, in fact, have more in common with them than just skepticism.
The members of the Brisbane Skeptics Society are our hosts this weekend. If you're from Brisbane or surrounds, please consider joining. If you're not from Brisbane, the Brisbane Skeptics do fantastic work as woo warriors here in the Sunshine State. So please consider making a donation in the box provided outside. And now, to open the convention, we'd like to introduce the President of the Brisbane Skeptic Society, Mr. Ross Balch.
Wow, can't believe it's finally happened. You know, Brisbane Skeptic Society, we're actually probably the youngest in Australia, except for perhaps the Northern Territory, which sort of arose recently. And it's fantastic to see that after all this time, there are still new groups popping up and doing good work. You know, our group started off as the Skeptics in the Pub. And, you know, it wasn't an especially auspicious start. Phil just put up a meetup. And people arrived, and I think that's what's great about community and the skeptics, and that we're so willing to do that kind of thing. And you know, like most groups, we sort of just kept meeting up, having drinks, because that's the most important part, of course. You know, the skepticism is secondary to the drinking and the chatting about anything else but skepticism most of the time. And you know, we never really imagined ourselves getting to this point here today. You know, making such good friends with Australian skeptics and skeptic groups around the country. But, you know, it came to a point, and I think in a lot of groups this happens, where you realise that you want to do more, you know, that it's come time to do something a little different. And we started that with a skeptic camp, and, you know, we'd only really heard of skeptic camps. None of us had ever been to one, and we had no idea how one of those would function. And, of course, there are plenty of people around Australia who've put them on before, and we decided that we'd do our own, and that was really successful, and we were really happy that so many people from the community came to support it. And we were surprised, to say the least, when we got a phone call from Iran asking us if we would arrange the convention this year. And really, it was hard to say no. You know, you get a call like this, and you get the chance to do something like this, and I think you'd be insane to turn it down, even if it's just for the challenge and to put something on that you can be proud of. So we have a lot of speakers here today from overseas, from national. There's a whole range of ages and different topics. And I think you're going to be really pleased with the show that we're putting on today and the quality of the speakers that you're going to see. So I think really what I wanted to say today is thank you for coming out here. It means a lot to us that really we're sort of building the community of just one meeting at a time. I mean, this is the 31st consecutive meeting of the Australian Skeptics, which is an absolutely amazing achievement, which I think deserves a round of applause. Woo! I think one of the things that we often get accused of at these events is preaching to the choir, which I think is a fair point. You know, I think, yes, okay, pretty much everyone here is a skeptic, and you're going to be a skeptic next year, you're going to be a skeptic in 5 years' time, you're going to be a skeptic in 10 years' time. But let's not kid ourselves that preaching to the choir isn't necessarily a bad thing. The fact is that part of being a skeptic is being educated and continually updating your education. It's important. I mean, the fact is that you can't call yourself a proper skeptic if you're going off assumptions that might be 10, 5 years old. And that's why these kinds of events are important. We get together in one room, we get to make plans and strategize for our world takeover plans.
Woohoo!
I didn't hear it. I definitely didn't hear that. But being together is important. I really never thought for a second, just 5 years ago, that when I learned what skepticism was, that I would be meeting people from all over the world and making friends. I mean, we could have very little in common except for our thirst for knowledge and our quest for the truth. And that's what Brisbane Skeptics are about. That's what the Australian Skeptics are about, and that's what this movement is about. So I'm really happy to see you all today. And look, have fun. That's the most important thing, right? So thank you very much. And I will have the other two guests come up, and they're going to perform a bit of a skit for you, which should be entertaining, hopefully. So thank you.